Hello friends, I am Dr. Prashant Sharma and you are watching MEDICO'S Hub. In this video on dental anatomy, I am going to discuss a question: describe the morphology of primary mandibular second molar. It is the last tooth of the mandibular and the maxillary arch in primary dentition. The primary mandibular second molar. Overall length is 18.8 mm, in which the crown length is 5.5 mm. And the root length is 11.3 mm. Then the mesiodistal diameter of the crown, which is largest in the primary dentition, is 9.9 mm. Then mesiodistal diameter of the crown at cervix, it becomes 7.2 mm. Labiolingual diameter of the crown is 8.7 mm, which becomes at cervix 6.4 mm. Now the buccal aspect. Although it differs in dimension, but feature wise it resembles the permanent mandibular first molar. Buccal aspect. First of all, we'll discuss the crown. This is the buccal aspect. Mesiodistal calibration of the crown. At the cervical portion, the dimensions are less than at the contact level. So this is the cervical portion, the contact level. So the dimensions at the cervical portion are less than the dimensions at the contact level. Mandibular first permanent molar is wider at cervical portion. Then three distinct buccal cusps of almost equal size are seen with two developmental grooves, which are mesiobuccal and distobuccal grooves. First one is mesiobuccal cusp. This is mesiobuccal cusp. Second is buccal cusp, which is this one. And in between there is distobuccal cusp, which is this one. The buccal surface is straight with three cusps. Mandibular first permanent molar has unequal buccal surface with three cusps, which are two buccal and one mesial. Now next is roots. Long and slender roots are there. We can observe that distal root is there, mesial root is there. Twice as long as crown. Dimensions are visible. This is the length of root, which is almost double to that of crown. These have a characteristic flare mesiodistally at middle and apical third. You can observe that these are turning like this. Point of bifurcation of roots immediately starts from the CEJ, that is cemento-enamel junction of the crown. Now this is the point of bifurcation very close to the cervical line. So this is about the buccal aspect. Now the next one is lingual aspect. Two equal lingual cusps are observed with a lingual groove in between. These are the two lingual cusps, that is distolingual cusp and the mesiolingual cusp. And these are having a groove between, that is lingual groove. These are not as wide as three cusps of the buccal side, thus making the crown more narrower lingual side. And cervical line is almost straight. We can observe the cervical line, which is almost straight. Mesial portion is slightly higher than distal portion. In cervical line, this is the mesial portion, which is slightly higher than the distal portion. A portion of three buccal cusps are also seen from this aspect. Like this is visible, this is visible. So these are the buccal cusps, which are also visible from the lingual aspect, a slight part of them. Then roots. Appearance of roots is almost similar to that of buccal aspect. Then mesial aspect. First of all, crown. Crown outline resembles the permanent mandibular first molar. That is, crest of contour is more prominent buccally in the permanent mandibular first molar. Then buccal cusp. These are paced over the root base and the lingual outline of the crown extends beyond the root base. This is the root base, lingual outline. This is the lingual outline, which is outer or it extends beyond the root base. Mesial marginal ridge is high, because of which mesiobuccal cusp and the mesiolingual cusp appears short. Lingual cusp is longer or higher than the buccal cusp. We can observe that this buccal cusp tip is higher and this cusp is relatively lower. Then mesial root is unusually broad and flat with a blunt apex. The apex is blunt and it is very broad and flat. It may be serrated occasionally. Now the next is distal aspect. The crown width distally it is less than mesially, so mesiobuccal and distobuccal cusp can also be seen from the distal aspect. Distolingual cusp is well developed, triangular ridge from the tip of the cusp extending down into the occlusal surface can be observed from this aspect. Now distal marginal ridge, it dips more sharply and is shorter buccolingually than the mesial marginal ridge. Cervical line, it is regular, although it has the same upward incline, slight incline buccolingually on the distal as on the mesial. We have observed that mesially it is almost straight. Distal root is as broad as mesial root but tapers more at the apical end. We have seen the apical end is very blunt in the mesial aspect. Relatively it is less blunt. Distal root is flattened at the distal surface. Now the occlusal surface. Occlusal surface. General outline is rectangular. Occlusal aspects show 5 cusps. 3 buccal cusps, these are of similar size. 2 buccal cusps, these are of similar size. We can observe these. First of all, buccal cusp. So this one is the distal cusp, distobuccal cusp and mesiobuccal cusp. So 1, 2, 3, these are 3 buccal cusp. And then lingual cusp, distolingual cusp, mesiolingual cusp, these are 2 lingual cusp. Total mesiolingual width of the lingual cusp is less than that of buccal cusp. This is mesial, this is distal, this is lingual and this is buccal. So this width is more and this width is less. Then each cusp ridge possesses well-defined triangular ridges. Triangular ridges end in the center of the crown buccolingually in a central developmental groove that follows a staggered course from the medial triangular fossa just inside the medial marginal ridge, top of the triangular fossa just mesial to the distal triangular ridge. So here is the distal triangular ridge, here is the mesial triangular ridge and this is the central developmental groove. Here we can observe the central developmental groove. This is the central developmental groove and that follows the staggered course is there from the medial triangular fossa to the distal triangular fossa. Now the distal triangular ridge is less defined than the mesial triangular ridge. From the central groove, developmental groove branch off both lingually and buccally. We can observe that distobuccal developmental groove is this and this is the mesiobuccal developmental groove and this is lingual developmental groove. So from the central groove, that is from the central developmental groove branch off both lingually and buccally. So buccally there are 2 grooves, 1 and 2, and lingually there is single groove. 2 buccal grooves are confluent or blended with the buccal surface, that is they are going just towards the buccal surface, one mesial and one distal. So one is termed as mesiobuccal developmental groove and another one is termed as distobuccal developmental groove. Single developmental groove is blended with the lingual surface of the crown. This is the single lingual developmental groove. Then mesial marginal ridge is there, which is better developed and more pronounced than distal marginal ridge. If we can observe that this is the mesial, this is the distal marginal ridge and here will be the mesial marginal ridge. So mesial marginal ridge is better developed and more pronounced than distal marginal ridge. Outline of crown converges distally. An outline following the tips of the cusp and the marginal ridges conforms to the outline of the rectangle more closely than does the gross outline of the crown in its entirety. In primary molar, mesiobuccal, distobuccal and distal cusp are almost equal in size. In the permanent molar, distal cusp is smaller than the other two, because of which the crown is narrow buccolingually in comparison to the mesiodistally. So this is all about the occlusal aspect of the primary mandibular second molar. Hit the like button, share and subscribe our channel to get the latest updates and notifications.